Thanks a lot, Cam. My name's Wyn Baptiste. I'm senior producer at the MTV Staying Alive Foundation. Thanks for the invitation to come and share some of our experiences and learnings from our flagship behaviour change campaign, MTV Shuga. I just want to share some kind of highlights, really, of what we've done most recently, but also what we've learned over the last 10 years of making this TV show, MTV Shuga. At the MTV Staying Alive Foundation, we are storytellers, and we're passionate believers that content can help make a difference and can really have a tangible effect in changing things. Our work is powered by the truth of young people's experience. We're a media movement that produces content that we hope allows and facilitates and enables and inspires young people to make good choices for themselves about their health. It's about behavior change, it's about generating demand for services, and essentially it's about engagement. MTV Shuga, I'm proud to say, is an award-winning campaign. It's centered around TV drama, but also includes factual content and a whole host of short-form content we use on digital. We've made 10 seasons so far. The action has been centered in Kenya, Nigeria, South Africa, and most recently in Côte d'Ivoire, which is our first foray into Francophone Africa. And right now we're running our first season in India. So firstly, just wanted to show you a taste of what we do.
We all have a story to tell. They're about choices.
You're 16 for crying out loud.
They're about helping each other out. About learning from each other.
She doesn't know about my status.
Tell her now.
About making mistakes.
Sorry, Mom, sorry!
You know how it is in the heat of the moment.
I swear I stopped when she started screaming.
Run them out!
Am I at risk?
What are you talking about?
HIV.
And overcoming adversity.
I forbid you!
Dad, you forbid me? I'm not a child!
They're about turning it up and bringing it back down. We're tuned in and turned on. They're about falling in love and falling out of love.
Are you trying to break up with me?
I just did.
They're about being different.
I said I'm gay. Did you even hear that part?
There's not a thing that I don't know about you.
About fighting for a better future.
Okay, no!
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 Dad, how would you even know?
HIV and AIDS are not even the same thing.
Whoop. Okay. I hope you got a bit of a sense of what we do at MTV Shuga, Staying Alive. I'm afraid the video's cut for some reason halfway through. But I hope that gives you a sense of the storytelling that we try and achieve with our television drama. And what you would have seen in the second half of the last minute of that VT was some of the documentary material we do that supports and reflects the storylines in the drama. So what is MTV Shuga? Well, it's more than a TV drama. It's episodic drama at the core of what we do in each campaign, but it's also documentaries. Oops, this seems to be flicking through of its own accord. Let me see if I can return to where we need to be. I don't know if I can have any technical assistance here, but all right. So perhaps, okay. I think we're here now. So I can just manually flick through. So from this slide, you can see we've got the television drama series at the centre, but there's a load more stuff that goes into a campaign. There's surround programming, which includes documentary. There's radio drama. One of the most exciting things for us is peer education, where the content is taken out into communities and we interact with people face to face. We're looking to open conversations which are often very difficult to have. We're looking to provide accurate information and connect people to support services. Our material that we put out digitally gives a really good opportunity for interactivity. And our partnerships are absolutely key. It's about service delivery, and of course it's about funding. So we give MTV Shuga away cost-free, rights cleared to broadcasters and on-demand platforms around the world. We're giving this away free, and the point of that is to try and get it out there on as many platforms as possible. We are discovering that in some territories, broadcasters want us to pay them to put it on. So sometimes we need to work that into our costings, and that's a bit of a new one. But generally, the model of giving away this content cost-free is really effective for us. We've made 10 series in 5 countries, as I mentioned. Ratings can be sometimes... accurate ratings can sometimes be hard to come by in the African continent. But as you can see on this slide, we're getting 2.8 million weekly views on SABC, the main terrestrial broadcaster in South Africa, which is a pretty good viewing rate for us. We also publish our material online. It's really, really important for us to have that presence, not just on broadcast television, when not everybody has access to it. Increasingly, digital platforms are really important to us. We're really, really active on YouTube. And that is also a really fertile place for conversations to happen. If you look at the comment section under each episode, that's where people are sharing their own experience, challenging one another. Christopher talked about empathy, where people are saying, yes, I connect to this. Yes, this reflects my life experience. And then there's a domino effect where other people join the conversation, and breaking down those sometimes intergenerational norms around attitude and in turn behavior is a really key thing for us to challenge. And on that slide, you'll see that so far we've reached 215,000 young people through peer education. So that may not be the millions and millions and millions that broadcast television and YouTube give us, but there's a certain quality to that peer education going out into communities where perhaps television doesn't reach, where perhaps the internet doesn't reach, where there can be that intimacy of conversation. Very much, I think, like DMI's, you know, experience and some of the stuff that Christopher has talked about. So what's our approach to all of this? I think the main headline is about putting young people at the center of everything we do. Very much like Catherine just talked about at DMI. At the formative research point, we are talking to young people about their experiences. So it's focus groups. Example, before our last Nigeria season, we did a survey. Well, we didn't, in fact, actually. It was people who know much more, more about conducting this did it. Tulane University went out for us, and they surveyed 5,000 Nigerian young people. And what that does is it throws up where the need is, what the barriers to change are, what the accepted attitudinal stuff is that we need to challenge. I'll give you one small example. In the survey, a result came back that young people were worried about using condoms because of stigma, that if they produced a condom, it somehow was saying, I am promiscuous. So rather than be stigmatized in that way, they'd rather not use a condom at all, which is clearly gave us a clear area for storytelling. You know, we could build characters and storylines around that nugget of information. And there is a myriad of different touch points like that. So we get an idea of what the landscape is. Our goal with every campaign is to ask tough questions and open up those conversations which are difficult to have. And we believe that, you know, if you engage and listen to your target audience, then surely your campaign is going to be more effective. We then push past that formative research stage and ask young people about their views on the messaging, on the stories. So we've got touch points with young people at every stage. So it's right at the beginning, and then it's when we've got some ideas about what the characters might be, and then the storylines and the scripts. We're constantly getting feedback from young people themselves. And that might be somebody saying, that's just not realistic, or they wouldn't say that, or yes, that's what happened when I spoke to my uncle. So we get an idea of where we need to take something out, amend something slightly, or that we're on the right track. We don't assume that our writers get it right all the time. We don't assume that we get it right all the time. And so that's a really good check and balance on what we do. We work to craft and mobilise our social media communities to discuss the storylines while the show's going out. We're getting instant feedback through social media. And I think the key thing here is the word for me is authenticity, really. Authenticity is the key. And I was talking to Christopher this morning saying, you know, we're always walking this tightrope between education, information, and entertainment. If we veer too much one way or the other, we ain't going to hit the mark. If we go too far towards the entertainment, we're missing out on the messaging. If we're too information heavy, well, the shutters will come down. I once was young myself, and being preached at was not necessarily the best way to get me to listen. So we're always trying to remind ourselves, we're not about preaching here. We're about opening the conversation, giving information, and trying to empower young people to make the decisions that are going to be best for them. Collaboration is absolutely key. Once we've got our funding in place, we approach production partners in country. We've got some pretty firm ideas about what makes a good TV show. We've got some pretty firm ideas about what makes a good script, performance, direction. But we don't want to parachute into a country. We want to harness the best of the talent that is there and let them lead it. Yes, we will act as executive producer. Yes, we will have a say and we will be involved, but it's got to be led by people at a local level who have the skills required, but understand the nuance, understand how to reach those local communities. Our most recent project has seen us establish a show in India. First time we've been outside sub-Saharan Africa. It's called MTV Nished. Nished translates loosely as taboo. The show tackles reproductive health, but also TB and nutrition. And these are two new health areas for us where we've leaned heavily on our partners for technical information. And of course, we're moving into a new territory. So it's been quite a process of getting to know the cultural landscape, which in India is varied, as you may know. And the finale of this 13-episode season actually is being broadcast this coming weekend. And we also produced more than 40 short-form videos that support the main TV drama. And I'll show you a bit of that, hopefully, in a moment. Our website and YouTube will include episodes, but lots of this short-form content that I've talked about. It gives an opportunity for our actors to talk through their characters and their storylines. Our actors become ambassadors always. You know, part of our casting is around how they perform, but also we're looking for people who are invested in the project. And we ask a lot of our cast, once filming is done, to be advocates for us in a number of ways. And online, we're also able to run polling, asking questions of the audience, which gives us, it's another litmus test on attitudes, really. We can put up blogs and frequently asked questions. And currently, more than a quarter of the web viewership, we're transmitting into polling views. So people are engaging at quite a high rate. There's an example here of some of our digital content and how we expand the narrative of our storylines. As I said, our actors actually become ambassadors. We're going to see Reza here, who talks about his character Vicky coming to terms with TB. There may be some Hindi speakers in the house, but for those who aren't, there are subtitles on this video.
That should go now.
My name is Reza, and I'm playing Vicky's character on the show. Vicky has TB. His own fault is because TB comes back. TB दोबारा आने के पहले निशान ये थे, बुखार सा लग रहा है, तबीयत खराब लग रही है, कमजोरी आ जाती है और खांसी बहुत आती है उसे.
Yeah bro, all okay? कोई तकलीफ तो नहीं ना?
First class.
जब विकी डॉक्टर के पास जाता है TB के सिम्टम्स के साथ, उसको ये महसूस होता है कि सबसे पहली बात ये क्यों हो रहा है मेरे साथ?
क्योंकि दवाई अपना काम कर रही थी और कोर्स कंप्लीट ना करके तुमने अपना काम तो किया ही नहीं.
विकी जब अपनी माँ को बताता है कि उसे टीबी हो गया है, तो माँ का बहुत ही फनी रिएक्शन होता है.
ये बार बार कैसे हो सकता है? पुत्र तू ठीक हो गया था ना? अभी तो तुझे पापा जी का बिजनेस भी संभालना है. कनाडा वाली बुआ जी ने इतनी सोनी लड़की की फोटो भेजी थी.
ये बेटे से शादी कौन करेगा? तो विकी को भी थोड़ा अजीब लगता है कि मेरी माँ क्या कह रही है. जब उसके मकान मालिक को पता चलता है कि उसे टीबी है और वो इलाज करा रहा है, उन्हें लगता है कि उन्हें भी हो जाएगा. और जो स्टिग्मा है हमारी हमारी सोसाइटी में कि दूर कर दो कहीं मुझे ना हो जाए, तो घर से बाहर निकाल देता उसका मकान मालिक उसे. तो टीबी किसी को भी हो सकता है. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि गरीब लोगों को होता है या दुबले पतले लोगों को होता है, ऐसा कुछ होता है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं. अगर टीबी होता है या कोई भी बीमारी होती है, तो आप प्लीज़ डॉक्टर की बात सुनिए और दवाइयाँ टाइम से लीजिए. अपना कोर्स ख़त्म करिए दवाई का, तभी आप ठीक हो पाएंगे. टीबी जो है छूने से नहीं फैलता है, हवा से फैलता है. बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है कि आप प्लीज़ अपना मॉरल सपोर्ट, अपना प्यार टीबी पेशेंट को दीजिए. टीबी पेशेंट जो है वो ये याद रखिए कि आप अपने आप को आइसोलेट मत करिए. तो दोस्तों, ट्यूबरक्लोसिस के बारे में और जानकारी के लिए आप प्लीज़ लॉग ऑन करिए mtvnisheth.com.
So we have dedicated websites and social media accounts for each campaign, with local in-country managers engaging with users wherever they can, and importantly, driving them to service providers in-country. Our digital allows us to do a huge amount of things. We can monitor sentiment and the issues we're talking about, but more importantly, we can bring users on a deeper journey. So all the digital content really gives added value. What we don't want to do is get people to watch the TV show and say, go to the website, it's quite good. It's go to the website, you're going to get added value. So that might be that pertinent information, that deeper dive, that helpline number, that forum that will answer your questions. So when people go to the website, they're pushed deeper into information gathering, but also hopefully given a chance to give their view and have a direction of travel in which to go to get the help and information that they will need. Well, I need to work out how to stop this thing moving on its own. So here are some of our results. In 2019, a cost-benefit analysis by the World Bank's Dime team estimated that for every $1 invested in MTV Shuga, $150 is returned in health and social welfare benefits. Another World Bank study, this was conducted between 2014 and 2017, it found that within 6 months of watching MTV Shuga, viewers were twice as likely to get an HIV test. I keep just having to flick back to hold us where we are. The prevalence of chlamydia amongst female viewers was almost halved. amongst male viewers, the level of concurrent sexual partners was reduced by 50%. And reporting of physical violence was more than halved amongst female viewers. Most recently, Tulane University has done a study on our latest work in Nigeria. In terms of reach, they found that 1 in 7 of our target audience in Lagos State had seen MTV Shuga. That's 600,000 young people. The numbers for females were slightly lower. It was 1 in 10, but that's still a significant number of young people in one particular geography. And we were really pleased to see that some of those kind of accepted ways of thinking, accepted core beliefs have been challenged. So there are improved norms around contraception and family planning. Oops. There's improved motivation to use contraception, and again, self-reported prevalence and acceptance of sexual violence was challenged. Within that area, we're really pleased to see that conversations amongst families and peers was greatly increased. And then the people were 4 times as likely to have heard of emergency contraception. Some of that very basic knowledge and awareness was something that our funding partners were really, really keen to address. So this is a midline study for our latest Nigeria. So we're looking forward to the end line study to see how the results are in the round. So in summary, I think why do we think our model works? One, we think it's atypical. There are lots of similarities with us and what Catherine talked about and some of the basic principles that Christopher talked about. But I think in terms of the broadcast television landscape, we're not typical. Shuga is seen as a genuine cultural asset. And I think what that means is that young people see it as a legitimate media thing that they consume alongside everything else that they watch on television or consume online. We leverage the MTV brand pretty effectively. The Staying Alive Foundation is a standalone, independent charity. MTV, Viacom, CBS does not pay for the shows. That's paid for by our funding partners. But MTV give us the office space, the legal support, the logistical building blocks that we need to run the organisation, but we remain independent, and they kindly allow us to use the brand, and that is key, because as Cam said as he introduced me, the MTV brand is recognisable. It's an open door for people to walk through, and indeed in the show itself we use music pretty effectively. So in terms of the soundtrack, we have top music artists making cameo appearances in the show, and that really is a gateway for our audiences to come in. As I've talked about a lot, we involve young people at every stage of the campaign, and we aim to tell their stories. It's not us telling them what to think. We're reflecting back their experiences and giving them options. We go wherever the young people are. Well, there are young people everywhere, but we look at where the need is most. And also it's important for us to have shared goals with our funding partners in particular regions. And as I've said, it's rights cleared, it's cost-free, we give the content away. And I think finally, just to say, I think that MTV Shuga has proved itself to be adaptable. So that's around messaging. So HIV has been the iron horse for everything that we do and has been our fundamental. But we've been able to expand into related health issues around sexual reproductive health, but also now TB, nutrition, looking at some of the broader well-being societal issues around gender equality, gender-based violence, intergenerational communication, some of those things that are kind of the building blocks and sometimes the barriers to change. So lastly, hopefully this will play. I wanted to show you this public service announcement that we made as part of our recent campaign in Nigeria around teenage pregnancy and contraception. It stars one of our actors whose character in the show goes through unwanted pregnancy. And I think that just this shows how we can bookend this 360-degree campaign. So we've had her storyline in the drama. We made an hour-long documentary about teenage pregnancy. We had all our materials online. And then this PSA kind of rounded things off in terms of awareness, but also pushing people towards the help that they need. And I think it shows that not everything we do is deadly serious.
I'm literally just finishing my studies. Yeah, I'll see you in a bit. Babe, please don't forget your hot date tonight.
I trust.
Oop. Sadly, it's not playing all the way through. I'll give it one more go to see if we can get it to play. No. I'm sorry. I think we'll have to give up on that. I'm sorry this has been a rather stunted and stop-start presentation. I hope you got a bit of a sense of the material that we produce. Thanks again for the opportunity to come and speak. I'm really looking forward to the panel discussion and answering any questions you may have. Thanks.